An evaluation of Motorola's Moto X phone with Android KitKat for use by the blind, with Peter Tucic, an assistive technology specialist at the Chicago Lighthouse.
Hello, my name is Peter Tucic, and I am an assistive technology specialist here at the Chicago Lighthouse. And the reason we're here today is to examine the accessibility features for the blind users of the Motorola Moto X phone. I'd like to thank Motorola for giving us this phone to demonstrate.
What do you like about the Motorola X?
One of the first things I wanted to point out with this phone is its ability for a blind person to use through where one would be using two hands to navigate with the phone to operate it. The back of the phone is curved in such a way that it makes it easy for someone to hold onto it. So I wanted to point that out, as in previous Android phones, a lot of the times we'll have a flat back, and sometimes it'll be harder for one to hold on to.
How can a blind person use the phone?
So what we're going to do is we will be using Talkback, which is a system that allows a blind user access to the touch screen of the phone. And this is an entirely touch-based phone. There are no actual buttons outside of the power button. And Talkback will allow the totally blind user the ability to interact with that touch screen. So we're going to turn the phone on, and it will
11:42 a.m.
tell us what time it is. Now, to unlock the phone, a blind person, what a blind user will do generally is anywhere one touches on the screen, it's going to voice that what is underneath the finger. So we're going to unlock the phone by sliding to the right.
Home.
Now, once we have the phone open and unlocked, we're on our home screen. Any place I would touch on the screen, Talkback will read what item is underneath my finger. So as I explore the touch screen, the voice will tell me what is underneath. So as I move,
folder, Google
folder, as I move down,
camera, back button, home screen 3,
and our home screen and
messaging,
whatnot, messaging, and
apps
and whatnot. As I move around, I will be able to find out what's under my finger. I also have the option to use gestures to move through the various options on the screen. By flicking right with one finger, I will toggle right and left, will toggle me through the various
home
screens.
Home screen 3, so folder, Google, folder, Play Store, search.
As I go right
voice
and left,
search,
that will alternate me through those. Now to select an item, for example, if I wanted to open up our apps folder, I could either swipe
camera
until I hit apps, and once I'm on apps, to select the item, I'm gonna double tap with one finger. And we're going to open our apps folder. Now again, once we're in the wherever we would like to be, as we move our finger around,
download,
we're
camera,
going to
big launcher free,
hear
big dialer.
Hear what's on screen in correlation to where my finger is on the screen, and I also have that option to swipe through.
Are there any features specific to Android that make using a phone as a blind user easier?
One of the nice things about Android, and in particular, we're running KitKat, and what Talkback allows for is quick navigation keys. They're shortcuts, essentially, which are two-part gestures, if you will. For example, an up and right will open up a menu, a down and right will open, and you can set what function you want each shortcut to perform. For example, right now, I always have a back button at the bottom left of my phone, which I just was able to find. But if I was in a hurry or if I didn't want to locate that button, one of those shortcut gestures is going to be the back gesture. It's going to be a down and a left, so a down flick and a left flick. And I'll demonstrate that now, and it will bring us back. In this case, it's going to bring us back to our home screen. So down, left, and we're going to be back on our home screen. Now, that allows a lot of convenience for any blind user, because it's going to give you the ability to, with those shortcut keys, open things like your notification center, context menus, if you need to turn off speech for a sighted user to use the phone quickly. Things. The one thing I think that's great about this phone, and great with Android, is that the blind user, and anybody, has the ability to, because the phone is using the Android operating system, it allows for much more openness in dealing with the programming side of things. If an app is available for an iPhone, for instance, you generally only can get that app through the App Store, through Apple. It has to be you know, has to comply with all the various codes and whatnot that Apple has in place. With Android, there's a lot more openness in the fact that open source programs can be run. You can install third-party applications and programs, and things, they don't necessarily have to, you know, just simply comply with being available on that Google Play Store, which is the App Store. And I think it's very important for someone who relies heavily on apps that are designed specifically for people with visual impairments or blind people to be able to have access to something that I could have a friend write me an app, write a program for me, and I can install it on my phone. And I think that's wonderful. And I've actually have had people do that for me in the past, and I'm able just to run those programs straight away.
How does Google Now work?
Google Now, which is essentially a way that you can use your voice to drive the phone. Google Now allows you to do everything from setting alarms to performing internet searches and calling contacts, sending text messages, and all of that. So we're going to find our voice search button, which will be on our top right of our
phone screen, voice search.
And now that we've found that, we're going to double tap. Again, double tapping will select that item, and we're going to ask our phone, we'll ask it a simple question. We'll see.
Google.
What is the temperature outside?
It's 11 degrees in Chicago right now.
How might this be useful as an everyday tool?
Google.
Wake me up at 6:45 a.m.
Setting alarm for 6:45 a.m.
Google, wake me up at 6:45 a.m.
So now it's going to
Google
set
search.
The alarm, and when it does it, it's going to confirm.
Alarm set for 18 hours and 57 minutes from now.
That our alarm has been set, and we can, you know, tell it to cancel the alarm or whatnot, whatever we'd like to do. But I use that commonly to wake myself up every morning.
How does Android's Talkback compare to Apple's VoiceOver?
I think one wonderful thing about Talkback is that the user has the ability to switch text-to-speech profiles at any time. With Apple's VoiceOver, you have the, you know, your vocalizer text-to-speech engine, which you know is fine. You can use it and whatnot. But for someone who prefers other voices, it really is nice to be able to install those various text-to-speech engines. If you have something you prefer one over the other, you can always install the voice data and simply activate that speech engine to switch voices. Also, the fact that we have those shortcut gestures speeds up everything from just navigating your phone, opening up menus much faster. You don't need to locate anything on screen, which is wonderful, and that really, you know, makes it easy.